Let's get in our guests then, and we are joined by Viburatan Dhara. He's AVP Commodity Research Bonanza, and Vijay Bambani is author and CEO BSPLindia.com. Vibhu, hi, let me start with you and the kind of run-up that we have seen in case of gold prices, 1620, it's at a multi-week highs. Do you see it sustaining, and how are you expecting it to perform in the US markets now?
Definitely. There are two reasons. The first is ECB latest comment, which we had seen lifting the euro against the dollar. Second thing, there is a stimulate hope from the Fed meeting, which is expected, due next weekend, this month end. These two things are supporting the gold prices presently. I think 1625 is the quite resistance level. If it's managed to break the same, the reachable target is somewhere around 1640 to 1650, or in the case of the domestic market, 29975 is quite a reachable target in the short term, as long as 29550 or 29300 is the support level.
All right, so buy, and the target's at 30,000 coming back in case of gold prices. But Vijay, what's the sense coming in for crude now? Because the ECB's latest statement is quite positive. We also have those Syria threats supporting the prices. Do you think it's going higher from here?
I think so. Let's also not forget, Manisha, something that I've been talking about since mid-June, that this is a hurricane season in the U.S. Any kind of development on natural disturbance front and crude prices can simply skyrocket. Having said that, I think in the absolute near term, you are seeing certain amount of weakness in prices. And if you're a very aggressive trader, and if you're looking at a quick entry and exit kind of a point, I think you might just want to take a chance with a small amount of short sales. But very strictly, your stop loss has to be very, very close to 5,015, 5,020 levels and no more. And even if you're selling, I think your basically quantity should be absolutely restricted, because the undercurrents at this point in time seem to be headed higher.
What's your sense? How would you be trading crude today?
Definitely. Apart from all this, there are more news from the global side also. Yesterday we had seen already IMF warned China's economy might be below 8%, which is also quite hurting the energy prices. Secondly, US data is not quite supporting as what we had seen in the last week or last 2 weeks. So these things likely to continue pressure on the energy prices. Definitely for the days to come, I am expecting 49 to 5020 is the trading band for the short period. But as long as it's not managed to sustain above 5025, I am not advising to go long as far as the domestic market is concerned.
Let's talk about the base metals then. And we started the day on a weaker note, but after the ECB comments, this sector also has seen a turnaround, especially within case of tin. That is down 7%, and we have seen the Chinese buying come back into that commodity. Is it quite significant, or would you rather look at other base metals than this?
I would rather look at other base metals for the simple reason that tin is not really very liquid here. And in terms of trades on the MCX, you'll find them few and far between. I would have seen sporadic handful of trades in the last one and a half years. I think one would stick to nickel. And I would continue with my bullish stance, which I advocated yesterday on nickel. The target that I had given out yesterday of 894, 895 levels has been met. And right now, I think as long as it sustains above the 882 levels, I think nickel is doing all right for itself. So I would initiate a long position in nickel at the current market price. I would hold that with a stop loss at probably 886, or give it a leeway of 2 more rupees. I would expect to book profits between 893 to 895 levels. And since this is the second day consecutive which nickel is showing signs of strength, I would taper down my exposure levels, because trying to extend your good luck to the second or third session can be a little hazardous here.
All right, Vibhu, how are you trading the base metals then, especially copper? Because we've seen strength come in that one as well. The LME is trading nearly 1% on the higher side, and there is turnaround for MCX as well. But is it going to last long?
Definitely, quite a supporting from the ECB comments only. But I don't think rest of the factors are supporting the base metal prices. What we had seen in China, US data, or I can say European crisis, all these things. This is what we had seen in the last few days. Copper is purely on the range bound move between 414, or I can say between 432. So on the Motamoti level, it's looking like a range bound move only. The aggressive traders can take a sell position. As per my view, aggressive traders can take a sell position on the rally with a stop loss of 424 for the target of somewhere around 414.
All right, so as of now, the commodities, of course, are reacting on the ECB comments, but whether it lasts long, whether there is actually a concrete statement or a step coming in from that one is what the markets would really be watching out for. Vibhu, thank you so much for joining us with your sense on all of those commodities there. Let's go for a short break with that. And we come back, we'll talk about how the government has begun work on the contingency plans as rains fail. The Consumer Affairs Minister, K.V. Thomas, says that the prices of pulses and edible oils may rise because of the dry spell. Also says that the centre may allow imports to keep the prices under control. And the Indian rupee gains following the euro higher following the ECB comments on the euro.